This is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us on this 4th of July. I'm Rebecca Vargas, along with Wendy Ross. It's the ladies' show this morning.
Yes, it
as
is.
The boys enjoy the holiday and a little sleeping in.
Yeah,
we can hold down the fort.
We're going to hold down the fort. And I have to say, things haven't changed since yesterday morning when it was already back up in the 80s at this hour.
Yes.
And we had some overnight showers. We haven't had anything really recently, but we did have some overnight showers that were mostly affecting the coastline. And that is what's going to happen again today. We may see a stray shower that comes on in. It's 79 degrees right now. We do have fair skies at this hour. And as you can see, dew points are high and the humidity is up there. The winds are coming in off the east-northeast area at 3 miles per hour. So they're calm. And what we're looking at right now around our region is the temperatures are mostly, we're seeing a mix of 70s and 80s right now. And we're going to warm up today to highs in the 90s. So it's going to be hot. You can see some of the showers that are forming down to our south. Overnight, we had the rain that came on in across Charlotte County and exited very quickly. So we're not going to be seeing a continuous pour this morning. What we are getting are temperatures that are going to stay quite warm throughout the morning. By noontime, we get up to 90, and the daytime high today is 93. So be prepared for a hot day with few showers.
Oh, yeah, stay hydrated. Taking a look at our roadways right now at 601. A couple issues right now at Palmetto. We're still seeing that little blip on the screen, a little partial blockage at 23rd Street and 41. So be aware of that, but no slowdowns because of it. And then down in Bayshore Gardens West, Conquistador Parkway has some debris on the roadway there at 43rd Street. So just be aware if you are traveling in that area. 41-301 and the interstate are clear right now from Manatee County down into Sarasota. No issues on 41 or the arteries out to 75, and we're accident and delay free even all the way down into Venice and Northport. Well, topping our news this morning, an investigation is underway into an accidental shooting that killed a 14-year-old boy at a gun range yesterday. It happened Sunday afternoon at the High Noon Gun Shop in the Ridge Center on Bee Ridge Road east of McIntosh. The shop owner says the boy was with his father when the shooting happened. He was then transported to Sarasota Memorial Hospital, where he later died. Detectives and the forensics unit were brought in to investigate. And another investigation is also underway into a suspicious death in Sarasota. Officers with the Sarasota Police Department were called to the 800 block of Mecca Drive on the North Trail Saturday night around 10. The name of the victim has not yet been released, but detectives say they believe it was an isolated incident and the neighborhood is not in danger. And at least two people were shot and injured after shots were fired inside a Palmetto nightclub over the weekend. It happened at the Hall nightclub at the 1300 block of US 301 North in Palmetto. Police say one man was shot in the chest and another shot in the leg. Both are expected to survive and several were hurt trying to flee the club. Police are still investigating and no motive or arrests have been made at this time. Well, it was a big weekend in Sarasota as thousands of people hit the beach for the 2016 Powerboat Grand Prix. But some business owners say the festival didn't make big waves for them. ABC7's Kate Flexter has that story.
It's that time of year again, the Sarasota Grand Prix. That means big boats and bigger crowds.
Excited to see the boats.
Oh, we're really excited.
But it also means the possibility of big business for local shops, restaurants, and hotels. Last year's festival brought in a massive $32 million, according to Visit Sarasota. And 85% of those in attendance said they planned on coming back next year. Patrick's on Main Street said Friday was unusually fast-paced for the off-season.
Everybody was happy, a lot of people on the street, and people came all the way to 10 o'clock to the end of the party.
The restaurant manager attributes much of that business to this year's block party in place of the usual boat parade, which he said encouraged people to take their time and sit down for a meal.
It's not a parade, so the people was walking all over the place, not sitting in one place watching the boats go by, and it was more like a party.
But others, like the Lido Beach restaurant, felt like last year's event brought in more business.
It was okay yesterday, definitely a little quieter than compared to last year.
Next person line, please.
The restaurant was preparing hours in advance for the big crowds they saw last year, but they were disappointed by this year's turnout.
Because we were here at 5 o'clock in the morning getting prepared and opened our window at 6, and again, it was not like last year.
For Green Zebra and St. Armand's Circle, it was a similar story.
We had a lot better Saturdays than this one this week.
They went ahead and brought in extra staff in anticipation of a big weekend.
All of the neighbors were saying that it's usually a big weekend, and we're really disappointed.
The final numbers in terms of economic impact for this year's festival have yet to be tallied, but event organizers are optimistic. Back to you.
Thank you, Kate. Well, it was more than just boats getting attention during the races this weekend. Look at this. Police Marine Patrol spotted a manatee floating near the race course. Police worked with state wildlife officials to guide the manatee away from the danger. And though the racing action is now over, the Powerboat Grand Prix Festival officially wraps up tonight with the Bayfront Fireworks Spectacular. The fireworks will fire off from Bayfront Park in Sarasota near Marina Jack, and they will begin at 9 o'clock. And those are just one of several fireworks shows that you'll be able to watch tonight. Other big events include 4th Fest in Palmetto, kicking off at 4 p.m. Smash Mouth will perform at 7, with fireworks planned for 9 o'clock along the Manatee River. On Siesta Key, the 26th annual 4th of July fireworks display are set to go off at 9 as well. The best viewing will be the south area along Crescent Beach. There will also be fireworks displays on the South Venice Jetty in Venice Beach, Minnesota Key in Englewood, the Northport High School Stadium, and the Sandbar Restaurant on Spring Avenue on Anna Maria Island. Well, when it comes to fireworks, you may be surprised just how many are illegal in Florida. The only ones that are legal are sparklers, glowworms, and snakes. But a loophole in the law allows an exemption for those who buy fireworks for agricultural purposes.
The type of legal fireworks that you can have in the state of Florida are basically the ones that emit showers of sparks and they do not leave the ground. If it self-propels or explodes, it is illegal. So, and especially Chinese lanterns are very illegal and very dangerous.
Sparklers can reach 1,200 degrees. And besides fireworks safety, road safety is also a concern today. The 4th of July weekend is one of the most dangerous on the roads, with nearly half of all accidents involving drinking and driving. So if you have too much to drink, you can get a free tow home. AAA will be offering free tow-to-go services until 6 a.m. tomorrow morning. The service is free to anyone who needs a safe way home within a 10-mile radius. The number to call is 855-2-TOW-2-GO. Some popular local singers spent the weekend getting in tune for today's big show. The Gloria Musicae Singers will honor Independence Day with a special performance at First United Methodist Church. They plan to sing all patriotic songs for the occasion, including selections by Irving Berlin and others. The event also features a salute to the armed forces.
It's an opportunity to recognize the anniversary of the Emancipation Proclamation and also to sort of draw together after some of the horrific events in Orlando recently and remember these times in our history that have been difficult and that we get through them.
Their show is this afternoon at 4:30 at the church at 104 Pineapple, just south of Main Street, and tickets are $30. Meanwhile, the 4th of July celebration on Anna Maria Island will kick off early this morning. The Anna Maria Island Privateers annual 4th of July parade begins at 10 a.m., and it will stretch the entire length of the island. Last year, an estimated 20,000 people gathered along the 7-mile parade route to watch with 115 parade entries and 850 participants. Veterans were also honored over the weekend in Nokomis. The event at the Disabled American Veterans Center was a World War II themed dinner and dance complete with the music and food popular in the 1940s. A great way to remember our veterans and lives lost during the Independence Day weekend.
Every day it's important to remember them, and we try to actually.
All proceeds from this event will assist local veterans. Well, some Siesta Key ambassadors are making sure the beach is clean following the holiday weekend. Miss Sarasota and Miss Siesta passed out trash bags to beachgoers yesterday. They're looking to raise awareness of the increasing issue of trash on the beaches since the county removed some of the trash cans from the sand.
A trash bag is actually the last thing you think of when you think of your cooler, your umbrella, your towels. You a lot of times forget a trash can, and it's really one of the most important things to bring out to the beach to keep it clean.
Hi, would you guys
They were sure to pass out biodegradable bags in case those don't make it into a trash can. A public hearing will be held tomorrow to go over plans for a new restaurant and bar on Main Street in Sarasota. Cask and Ale plans to open next to Evie's Tavern. But some residents have complained, saying that it would create more noise downtown and give the downtown area more of a nightclub feel. After approving plans for the new restaurant, though, the city commission delayed a final vote on the development until they could hold the public hearing. This hearing will begin tomorrow night at 6 o'clock at City Hall on First Street. An update now on a story we first told you about last month after the Northport Police Department showed up to a little boy's birthday party when no one else came. The department just held a party now for other children who had been in a similar situation. Yesterday, kids gathered at Dallas White Park to enjoy bounce houses, t-shirts, desserts, and some entertainment. A local farm also brought animals to interact with the children facing challenges. The father of the boy who gave the police department the idea for this party was very pleased.
We'd like to do a birthday bash for everyone who's never had a birthday, people with autism, everybody. People that have never shown up for one kid's party. We want to do this for everybody that this happened to. And just today in general is about all that. And it's been awesome.
Here's a picture from that party last month that was saved by police. This picture was shared around the world, in fact. And today, Daniel received plenty of gifts from the community at the party. Actually, this was yesterday. So he was able to kick off something very awesome for
a lot of children
just like him. So it's incredible to see that. And he said those police were his superheroes. So who doesn't want their own superheroes at their birthday party?
No kidding. And especially when they're local and they are right out there and helping us all. So we are looking at some very warm weather for today. No big surprises here. We're going to have a complete look at the forecast when we get back.
And as people across the nation celebrate our independence, airports and major attractions will be on high alert following recent terror attacks. More on that story coming up.
Mom needed more care than we could provide, so we called Granny Nannies. She now has around-the-clock caregivers, and we have peace of mind. Thanks to them, she's where she belongs, at home.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Thanks to my volunteer, I am a better eater.
Thanks to my volunteer, math seems simple now.
Thanks to my volunteer, I discovered new career goals.
I'm a volunteer for Sarasota County Schools, so I know I can make a difference. And you can too. Give an hour, change a life.
Hurricane season is here. Are you prepared? ABC7 has the information you need. Access our special Surviving a Hurricane now. Learn how to prepare a readiness plan and survival kit. Know your evacuation route. Be prepared, Suncoast, when severe weather threatens. Access our special on our ABC7 app and all our live streaming platforms.
Apple TV, Amazon Fire TV, and...
Don't miss the 32nd annual Sarasota Powerboat Grand Prix Festival, June 25th through July 4th. This year's festival features a kickoff party at the Sarasota Yacht Club, boats on main block party, 2 days of aquacross and powerboat racing off Lido Beach, bayfront fireworks, and so much more. Produced by and benefiting Suncoast Charities for Children. For festival info and VIP race day viewing tickets, visit SarasotaPowerboatGrandPrix.org.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. The next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, and services.com, A-N-D, services.com.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
At Granny Nanny's, we provide your loved ones with the care they deserve. Compassionate and experienced help right where you need it most, at home. Visit us at grannynannies.com.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Taking a look outside, you can see we have fair skies out there. Right now, things are quiet. We had a couple of morning showers early this morning around the Charlotte County area. Those showers have now dissipated, and all of our viewing region is looking at fair skies at this time. So we're going to start to see some continued rains developing down to our south, and you can see them here on radar. But notice that we did have the showers that came in the overnight time period, and then they dissipated pretty quickly as they moved off towards the north. At this hour, things are quiet all across the region, across central Florida, and it's going to be one of those mornings where we're going to see maybe a stray shower that comes on in, and that's going to be about it. Along the coastline, 79 degrees for us right now, our humidity at 88%. Winds are coming in off the east northeast at around 3 miles per hour, and our temperatures range from 74 in Jacksonville all the way to 85 in Key West. And no one's really reporting any rain this morning. We are looking at a couple of showers that were down to the south of Fort Myers that are going to start to make their way on up towards the north. Temperatures right now are mostly in the 80s. For our region, we have Venice and Englewood reporting 81 degrees. It's very warm on Longboat Key, 84 there, 83 in Anna Maria. And then as you get onshore, we're starting to see some 80s popping up. Farther to the east, we still have temperatures in the 70s right now. We have high pressure that's building out in the Atlantic. We have this low pressure system here. Those two forces helping to bring those winds straight in out of the south, and that's what's going to be taking place for the most part today. And as a result of that, we're going to be seeing some morning coastal showers developing, and then we'll get the afternoon inland showers. But there's only a 20% chance of rain for the rest of the day, and we've got highs back up into the 90s. As warm as it was yesterday, it's going to be just as warm today. And as you can see, we've got those showers that we're going to be seeing. This is for our future cast. We're going to be getting the rains coming in from the south. We'll also see these showers start to move on up towards the north, and then we get the inner showers developing over the inland sections, and they'll be moving off towards the east. That will be taking place a little bit later on this afternoon. So again, just a stray shower may come on through throughout the morning hours. In the meantime, it's quiet out on the Atlantic. We don't have anything going on here. We have a series of high pressure systems out in the Atlantic that's suppressing any kind of activity. We're getting a little bit of cloud cover here across the Caribbean, and as you can see, there's nothing going on in the Gulf of Mexico, but it is very active in the Pacific. So Agatha has formed as of yesterday, and we also have Blas, and Blas is very close to hurricane strength. Also, all of these systems are moving away from shore, away from land. And as far as we're concerned, we're looking at winds today out of the southeast for boaters, 5 to 10 knots, seas 1 to 2 feet with a light chop. It'll be a perfect day to get out to the beach. Temperatures are going to be in the 80s. It's going to be warm in the water, and we're not expecting very much in the way of rain. We've only got a mix of clouds and sun throughout the morning hours with temperatures in the 80s. During the afternoon, we climb to a high of 93 and only a 20% chance of rain. Rebecca.
Thank you, Wendy. As far as our commute right now at 618, still out of Palmetto, we're seeing that one blockage of a road right there at 23rd Street. It's partially blocked at 41 if you're heading over the DeSoto Bridge, but it's not slow at this point due to that. As you take a look at Bayshore Gardens, El Conquistador Parkway, there's a report of debris on the road right there at 43rd Street. But 41301 and the interstate are clear at this point in the morning into Sarasota. No slowdowns or issues to report. And as far as Venice and Northport, looks like we are accident and delay free. Well, runners and Suncoast businesses are taking a closer look at a community fitness program. ABC 7's Don Brennan has the details in today's Donnie B. Fit.
The third annual Ton of Fun Challenge is off and running at Fleet Feet. Anyone can join in, and all you need is a desire to move your feet.
The response has been great. We've been getting the word out to all kinds of people in the community and local businesses. We've gotten great responses.
They had 150 people last year, so they expect more this year. And what is it exactly, you ask?
I kind of think of it as a weight loss and fitness accountability program. So we all know that we're much more successful with being healthy and fit when we have accountability partners.
It feels like a lot less like you're on your own doing a weight loss program. It feels like we are a big group of people that's all going through the same things, and so I think just that sense of community has really helped.
It is a fitness program, but Martlett and Fleet Feet do all the heavy lifting.
Some people don't go to gyms or don't hire a personal trainer or don't go into healthy grocery stores because they're nervous. Oh, I can't do that. I don't know anything about it. So we're taking the scary part out of it. You know, we're creating those relationships here at Fleet Feet.
Many local businesses take part in, or at least take note of, this program because healthier workers affect the bottom line in a good way.
Corporate wellness is a hot topic right now, and so a lot of businesses really want their employees to be healthy and fit because we all know that helps with so many things in life. So we've gotten some great responses from a lot of local businesses.
They have a host of programs, and registration is open for another week or so.
I created partnerships with local health and wellness professionals and had them come in and help me provide the content for the program. So, you know, workouts, clinics, cooking demos. We have nutritionists come in and analyze food journals. I mean, it's just a truly amazing content.
For ABC 7 and your Suncoast News, I'm Don Brennan.
Thank you, Don. Still ahead on Good Morning Suncoast, Uber looking to keep people safer while out celebrating the holiday today. We'll show you what they're doing next.
Hurricane season is here, and Suncoast weather can go from this to this in seconds. So when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7.
We're armed with the most advanced weather technology so that we can bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
Plus, we focus on the Suncoast and track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
U.S. Med has great news for anyone living with diabetes.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, U.S. Med will ship a new glucose meter right to your home.
And shipping is free.
My new meter uses only a speck of blood, so it's less painful than my previous meter.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, you're covered with U.S. Med. We're welcoming new patients, even if your current provider can't supply you anymore.
I don't even have to test on my fingers anymore. I can test on my hand or forearms, and it's more accurate than my old meter.
So call US Med today, and you'll have a choice of two great meters.
One that actually speaks your results, or a meter so small it fits in the bottle of strips.
Act now, and US Med will include a free prescription discount card. We'll also send you a free diabetes cookbook. This is your opportunity.
So call US Med today.
You'll be glad you did.
They say good things come to those that wait. Well, you've waited long enough. You deserve to feel fabulous in your fashionable new Fiat 500X from Alfa Romeo Fiat in Sarasota. Boldly innovative, seductively stylish. Fiat gives you everything you'd expect from a capable utility vehicle, like a spacious interior and advanced safety systems, designed and built like a sexy little sportster. Don't wait any longer. You deserve to feel fabulous. Get a new Fiat at Alfa Romeo Fiat of Sarasota.
The kitchen is where life happens. Minnesota Flooring now offers a wide variety of beautiful quality craft-made cabinetry to make sure the heart of your home reflects your style. Visit us today at our new kitchen and bath cabinetry locations.
Getting older shouldn't mean giving up all the things she loves to do.
it should just mean, well, finding new ways to do them. Right at Home's professional team thoughtfully selects caregivers to provide help with personal care, housekeeping, and of course, meal preparation.
Oh, that smells so good.
Oh, and it tastes good too.
We can provide the right care right at home.
Welcome back at 6:24, and Uber is doing what it can to keep some Americans safe this holiday weekend. Details now from ABC's Sunny Hostin and Kendis Gibson with this morning's Tech Bites.
In today's Tech Bites, Uber is joining the effort to keep drunk drivers off the roads on this July 4th holiday.
The ride-sharing service teamed up with Nevada's Public Safety Department to offer new customers discounted rides for the holiday. $5 from each ride will be donated to Mothers Against Drunk Driving. And Facebook can now make you look like a linguist.
That's right. The social network will display your messages in the preferred language of your readers, if you so choose. Until now, readers could ask that posts be translated. This will be automatic. Facebook says half its active users speak a language other than English. And Katy Perry is no dark horse when it comes to the Twitter sphere. The singer has been named the most followed person on Twitter.
Now, Perry has more than 90 million followers on the social media site. Coming in a distant number two with 83 million, Justin Bieber. Those are your Tech Bites.
Have a great day.
These pants always smelled like yoga aroma. I'd wash them and it'd be back before I even got to class.
Then I found Tide Odor Defense. It gets out and keeps out the yoga aroma wash after wash. Eliminate odors with new Tide Odor Defense. If it's got to be clean, it's got to be Tide.
Nexium 24-Hour introduces new, easy-to-swallow tablets. So now there are more ways for more people to experience complete protection from frequent heartburn. Nexium 24-Hour, the easy-to-swallow tablet, is here.
Mr. Brady, we've been expecting you. Will you be needing anything else?
No. Not a thing.
Beauty Rest Black. Get your beauty rest.
On your TV. On your computer. On your camera. On your smartphone. On your Apple Watch. And now you can get ABC7, your Suncoast News on Fire TV. Just go to mysuncoast.com and click on the mobile tab for a list of fast and free downloads that deliver ABC7, your Suncoast News, on the go.
ABC7's Pump Patrol, a list of the Suncoast's cheapest gas on mysuncoast.com.
Hurricane season is here, and so is the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. This essential resource arms you with vital information you need to protect your family and property when severe weather threatens the Suncoast, including how to create your readiness plan and survival kit, shelter locations, what to do with pets, and important phone numbers. Visit mysuncoast.com and download the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7, brought to you by the Florida Lottery.
This is a special health alert for seniors suffering with joint pain. If you have Medicare insurance, you may qualify for high-quality support braces at little or no cost.
I'm thrilled with my knee braces.
Now, there is a simple and proven solution for seniors to get out of pain with state-of-the-art support braces.
I barely feel any pain at all.
Braces for your knees and back, as well as your shoulders and ankles, too.
I'm so happy with the quality of these braces.
Call now, and you could qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost.
I can play ball again, and it doesn't hurt.
And because of my Medicare coverage, it costs me next to nothing.
So call now.
And because I have this red, white, and blue Medicare card, my braces have cost me just about nothing.
It's true. You may get a knee, back, shoulder, and ankle brace at little or no cost.
They qualified me for two knee braces and a back brace.
If you have knee or back pain, give them a call. They can help.
1-800-476-8967. 1-800-476-8967.
Discover the biggest savings of the year on some of America's favorite vehicles during the Drive and Discover event going on now at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. Get four-wheeler magazines 4x4 of the decade, a new Jeep Wrangler as low as $25,999, or drive away in a new Jeep Cherokee for just $19,999. Get a new 2016 Jeep Patriot for just $14,999. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
They took that stress and that tension when I was particularly feeling very bad after that nasty car accident, and it was such a relief to know that I didn't have to bear that burden alone, that I had help.
Our goal is to not just get a satisfactory settlement on their case, we want them up on their feet, happy again. They've gotten their life back.
Coming up on Good Morning Suncoast, as the nation celebrates its birthday, it's also on high alert as many events are seeing an increase in security. We have the details. Plus, why some 4th of July celebrations are being canceled in Florida and how you can stay safe during tonight's fireworks shows.
Live from the ABC 7 studios, this is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Welcome back. Thank you for joining us on this 4th of July. I'm Rebecca Vargas, along with Wendy Ross,
yes,
who's dialing up the heat, because as soon as I walked out the door, it's just thick.
Yeah, it is.
Get ready to stay hydrated.
Thick is the word. Mm-hmm. And you do want to stay hydrated today, because today is going to be one of those days where we climb back up into the 90s. It was very hot yesterday. It's going to be hot again today. And we're not going to get much of a break from it, because we aren't going to be seeing a whole lot in the way of rainfall.
Well, that's good
news. So that's good news, because on a holiday, we don't need the rain. That is for sure. 79 degrees right now, and it is very sticky outside. The winds are calm. We have fair skies. We don't have rain around right now, but we've got some showers that are forming down to our south. You can see readings right here are in the 70s and 80s, and the showers are becoming a little bit more numerous right off the coastline of the Fort Myers area, and then everything is moving on up towards the north. Now, overnight, we did have some rain that hit the Charlotte County area, but nothing is going on right now. So if you're heading out the door right now, you don't have to worry about any problems as far as the roadways are concerned. We are looking at temperatures that will climb to 90 by noontime, but the official high today will get past 90 degrees, and we are going to see a stray shower that comes on through with only a 20% chance of rain later today.
Thank you, Wendy. As far as our commute right now, out of Palmetto, we're still seeing that roadblock right there at 23rd Street. It is partially blocked at 41, and now volume is starting to pick up in that area. But the interstate and the bridges over Palmetto are moving along nicely. 41, 301 clear. We are seeing still in Bayshore Gardens, El Conquistador Parkway. There is debris on the road at 43rd Street to just be vigilant about as you travel in that area. But 41, 301 and the interstate are clear into Sarasota. I'm not seeing any delays or slowdowns. And 41 is clear into Venice, Northport. So is the interstate. So we're not seeing any issues there on our roadways in Sarasota County. Well, it's the much anticipated July 4th and the 240th birthday of America, and celebrations are already kicking off amidst security concerns.
From the joy of fireworks displays to terrifying explosions, this year's 4th of July follows deadly attacks this month around the world. Across the country, major airports upping security, uniformed and undercover officers monitoring train and bus stations. The NYPD keeping an eye on the city's famous landmarks, including Times Square. In our nation's capital, officers checking bags at the annual fireworks display and parade as the National Archives celebrates the 240th anniversary of the Declaration of Independence. In the meantime, fear sparked Sunday at New York City's Central Park.
I have no idea what it was. It sounded like a cannon.
18-year-old Connor Golden was seriously injured after stepping on an explosive. Police believe the device may have been there for some time, but have ruled out any ties to terror. Law enforcement is also monitoring radical Islamist threats as Ramadan ends Tuesday evening. ISIS using the holiday as a call to arms.
Be cognizant of perps possibly wearing explosives.
And the Department of Homeland Security is now urging those of you heading to large events to be vigilant and aware of your surroundings as you enjoy a happy and safe July 4th. We're learning now more details about that explosion in Central Park, and officials with the NYPD Counterterrorism Unit say they believe the explosion was caused by an experiment of fireworks in a homemade device. Witnesses say they could hear the explosion blocks away. Police are still trying to determine who the device belonged to. The victim and his friends were cleared, but officers say that they were definitely innocent.
There's nothing to indicate that this was an explosive device that was placed or put in this area with a specific intent to harm any individuals.
Golden suffered a severe leg injury, and he was taken to the hospital and underwent surgery. He could face a possible amputation of his leg. He is in serious but stable condition. Back here in Florida, new details about last month's gator attack that killed a boy at Disney World. The father of toddler Lane Graves says that when he tried to rescue his son, a second gator began attacking him. Matt Graves says the second gator came out after his son was pulled into the water at the Grand Floridian Resort. The family had been walking in shallow water there near the water, but nearby signs had warned against swimming but didn't mention anything about alligators. Wildlife crews later removed and killed five alligators from that lake. Well, thousands of protesters hit the beach angry about an algae emergency from Lake Okeechobee. Demonstrators filled Stewart Beach on the East Coast and formed the words, "Buy the Land." The group wants the state to purchase 50,000 acres to store water from the lake. Pollutants from the lake were flushed out to sea, which caused the massive bloom of foul-smelling algae.
We're sending a message today. This is what the people want. We want you to buy the land and start sending the water south. Stop polluting our paradise.
Four of the affected counties are on the East Coast. The fifth is Lynn Lee County, which is just southwest of the lake. 4th of July festivities have been canceled in Stewart due to this algae. Here on the Suncoast, there were plenty of new things to see and do on Lido Beach this weekend during the Sarasota Powerboat Grand Prix. But despite all that, some thought the turnout was low. ABC 7's Adam Cellini has the story.
Jason Russo remembers watching several Sarasota Grand Prix long before he was ever a part of it.
I came to from a small little child, came here with my father bringing me here, and so obviously it was a highlight of my weekend being able to race for a second year in a row here.
The Bayshore High alum now runs jet skis on the Aquacross circuit, one of the Grand Prix's new Saturday races.
The watercraft racing definitely is something that I think a lot of people can relate to, because this thing is not too far off what you can go buy from your local dealer and actually come out and compete. You're not necessarily made with the pro guys like us, but you can definitely go on the amateur level.
After decades of only powerboat races on Sundays, P1 added the jet skis and single-engine stock boat racing to the weekend last year.
What we're trying to do is really show a full weekend of marine motorsport action with all different types of racing, and show really a progression of how you can evolve within the sport.
But fans like Angela Stapley are still partial to the big boats.
I want to see the monsters. The jet skis were cool. Like, I've never really seen them race, but yeah, I'm all about seeing the big boats, watching them just launch.
And others may be getting wise to the act. After a heavy Saturday turnout last year, vendors were surprised to see low attendance early.
Just hoping for the best, hoping that after this race, perhaps we'll get some people coming in and getting some food and drinks, but it's been definitely like quieter.
As the power boats hit the water for a midday practice run, the crowd eventually rolled in. And even if you don't like the other races, Emma Shetler says people should still come for the tailgate.
Everybody gets to know everybody. We're in close quarters. Everybody's really respectful, and it's a great day out at the beach.
Adam Cellini, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Thank you, Adam. A deep dive for a Rays fan at Tropicana Field. A foul ball lands there on the tarp during the seventh inning, and a very eager fan climbed onto the tarp to grab the ball. He looks pretty proud of himself, but security wasn't too pleased with his antics and escorted him out of the stadium, but not before he got some cheers. He even got a little standing ovation from a young fan. So he went out in victory. He'll never forget that, the day I, you know, jumped on the tarp and grabbed the ball.
Oh, he has a story to tell.
What a souvenir, right?
No kidding. Well, I will have your forecast after the break.
We are delighted to have Dr. Kaminsky join our team at the Tutola Cancer Center.
I'm a radiation oncologist. I was at the National Institutes of Health, most recently at the Medical College of Georgia, specialized in central nervous system cancers, prostate cancers, and other types. At the Tutola Cancer Center, we have a level of technology that is second to none.
He has a great wealth of knowledge and shares the same passion that we have for patient care.
My family and I are happy to be here in Sarasota and excited to treat our patients here at the Tutola Cancer Center.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, and services.com, andservices.com.
This Sarasota Powerboat Grand Prix Minute is brought to you by Florida Leather Gallery.
Your support during the Grand Prix Festival makes a big difference. Loveland Center in Venice is one of five area nonprofit agencies receiving support from Suncoast Charities for Children and the Suncoast Foundation. Thanks to a recent grant from Suncoast Charities for Children, a multi-sensory room was renovated for clients with autism and other severe disabilities, and allowing program money to go directly to clients.
Florida Leather Gallery is celebrating the 4th of July with spectacular savings. Take 33% off hundreds of styles. Experience freedom of choice with a wide and wonderful assortment of leathers. Freedom from worry with our impressive collection of protected leathers. And freedom from guilt as we proudly offer the lowest price guaranteed. Plus, free delivery. It's all happening right now. Come celebrate with our Lexperts at our 6 Florida Leather Galleries.
Well, we are looking at a couple of clouds located well offshore as we're overlooking the waterway right now, and we are not expecting to see any real rains coming on through here throughout the morning hours. There's only a 20% chance of showers in our forecast. And that's because most of the rain has developed offshore and down to the south. It's traveling on up towards the north right now, but we're not getting any rain at this hour. So mostly fair skies for us. And we are, of course, very warm, very humid this morning as you step out the door. You're going to notice that first thing. It's not going to be much of a surprise. It's pretty much like yesterday's weather. So we're going to see the same sort of thing today. But this is where most of the rain is now showing up on radar. And it's just down to the south around Fort Myers. And we're starting to see some of these showers that are beginning now to be apparent right off the coastline of the Charlotte County region. Overnight last night, we had the rains that came through Charlotte County and then continued to move on up towards the north. But right now, most of us reporting fair skies with those clouds off in the distance, because at the airport, we've got nothing but sunshine right now. 79 degrees for us at this hour. Humidity is high. The winds are calm. Dew points are high as well. And as you can see around the state, we've got temperatures that range from 74 degrees in Jacksonville, all the way up to 85 degrees in Key West. And our area also reporting some warm temperatures, 84 in Anna Maria and Longboat Key. Right along the water, we're looking at temperatures in the 80s. And Bradenton also at 80 degrees. The rest of us are coming in the 70s at this hour. And again, fair skies for all. We've got a low pressure system that's around to the northeast of Texas. And we've got high pressure out in the Atlantic. These two forces are going to allow these winds to come in out of the south. And that's why we're seeing the development of the showers south of us and moving towards the north. So that's going to continue throughout the morning hours. And we may get a morning coastal shower, but it's going to be very sporadic and it's going to be coming on through very quickly and moving off very quickly as well. Afternoon inland showers are also expected. We've got a 20% chance of rain throughout the day, so our rain chances stay low, and that allows those highs to climb well into the 90s today. We're expecting to see a high of about 93 degrees. So this is what it's going to look like by the afternoon hours. We may start to get a couple of showers popping up, and that'll take place inland, and then these showers will move off towards the east. By tomorrow during the evening, or by tonight during the nighttime hours, we'll see the rain staying offshore. So we're not expecting to see anything to mar the picture for tonight. If you're heading out the door tonight, we shouldn't be seeing any problems. Again, only a 20% chance of rain in our forecast for the rest of the day, with most of those showers taking place inland. We will be seeing nothing out in the Atlantic. It's very quiet. We've got a series of high pressure systems out there keeping things quiet for us right now. We've got a little bit of cloud cover here in the Caribbean. The Gulf of Mexico is quiet. You have to head to the Pacific to find any action. And right now we've got Agatha, a minimal tropical storm, and we also have Blaz. And Blaz is moving off towards the west northwest. They both are moving away from land. It is expected to become a hurricane later on this morning. For boaters today, winds will be coming in out of the southeast at 5 to 10 knots, seas 1 to 2 feet with a light chop. The temperatures at the beaches will be slightly cooler than the rest of us, so it'll be a great place to go. This morning, we're going to see our temperatures in the 80s. We'll see a mix of sun and clouds. We've only got a 20% chance of showers developing. Later on this afternoon, we'll see inland showers with a temperature high of 93. We keep rain chances low for the next several days, but the temperatures are high for the entire week long.
Thank you, Wendy. Taking a look at traffic right now at 6:45. It looks like the Palmetto partial blockage is still being reported there. It's on US 41 southbound. It's partially blocked at 23rd Street. So just be aware, not seeing slowdowns because of that. Both of the Palmetto bridges are clear at this point in the morning. In Bayshore Gardens, there is debris on the road at El Conquistador Parkway and 43rd Street, but the Interstate 41, 301, all are clear right now into Sarasota. No slowdowns or accidents to report in Manatee or Sarasota County. And as you head into South County, Venice, Northport, that's all clear on the interstate and on 41. No accidents to report. Well, amidst the July 4th festivities, sometimes we forget that fireworks are actually explosives. ABC 7's Alex Redmond has more on when injuries can occur and how to avoid those injuries.
Thinking about lighting up some fireworks this 4th of July?
Even a sparkler can burn if you hold it too close to where the fire is burning at. So we see a lot of hand burns, forearm burns.
Emergency physician Dr. Ryan Snitowski explains these are some of the injuries that he's actually seen.
Previous in my career, while I was a resident, I saw a gentleman who put some fireworks in a fire hydrant, and when he went to light it and it wasn't exploding the way he wanted, he went back to check on it and it blew off the top of the hydrant, which went right through his face.
That man, says Dr. Snitowski, suffered a severe injury and was a major trauma patient.
The New York Giants, one of their defensive linemen, Pierre Paul, I believe, lost a finger in a fireworks accident, and he's a professional athlete, so.
Lighting a firework, unless you're a professional, may be hazardous to your health.
We've seen all types of really severe injuries, severe burns, lacerations, amputations. Fireworks can blow up in your face and actually cause you to lose your eyesight.
Fireworks alone can be dangerous, says SMH's trauma services manager Jennifer Sweeney.
Even more so if you're under the influence of any substances. You tend to have slower reaction time and are maybe not thinking through the process.
And if you think nixing your own pyrotechnics unpatriotic, consider this.
Most of them are made overseas because it's cheaper, China, I'm sure.
And this.
As the veterans come in, a drop of a bottle, any sudden noises can make them go off their chairs. Can you imagine with the fireworks?
Particularly combat veterans, says Eva Halschult, canteen manager of VFW 3233 in Sarasota.
Many of them have never gotten over it. PTSD is very serious. Some people just don't realize how serious it is.
Just because it's 4th of July doesn't mean you have a responsibility to set off your own fireworks. I think you can celebrate in other safer ways. My personal preference is go to the professionals, watch a nice fireworks display. Those are much safer. You're watching from a distance, and they're actually, in my opinion, more fun to watch anyway than the ones that you could set off on your own.
Reporting in Sarasota, Alex Redman, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
In health news, butter. It's a good to go to add to a little bit of flavor to your meal, but it's not so good for our health. A new study is showing, though, that it may not be as unhealthy as you think. Researchers at Tufts University churned back time to look at 9 past studies, and they found 1 extra tablespoon of butter a day means a 1% increase in your chance of dying from any cause. But the risk wasn't linked to any disease in particular. Researchers also found there was a 4% decrease in risk for diabetes with a daily tablespoon of butter. In entertainment news, President Obama is preparing for his final 4th of July celebration at the White House. The Independence Day concert on the South Lawn of the White House is scheduled to include performances by Grammy-nominated singer-songwriter Janelle Monáe and Grammy-winning rapper Kendrick Lamar. The annual event for military families also includes a barbecue and, of course, fireworks. At the box office this weekend, Dory continues to swim away from the competition. Finding Dory still remains in the top spot for the 3rd straight week. It earned $41 million in the U.S. Tarzan came in 2nd with $38 million in its debut, while the horror sequel The Purge: Election Year debuted in the 3rd spot with $30 million. Steven Spielberg's adaptation of the BFG opened with a weak $19 million. From actor to teacher, Matthew McConaughey will have to be referred to as Professor McConaughey this fall. He's set to teach a course on filmmaking at the University of Texas at Austin. The university says that the Oscar winner will teach at his alma mater alongside Hunger Games director Gary Ross. He will take 30 students behind the scenes of his latest film, The Free State of Jones, through recorded videos. What an incredible opportunity those students must have. Well, still ahead on Good Morning Suncoast, heating up the grill seems to be a staple on 4th of July. It also is heating up the competition in Coney Island. We'll have the details on the tradition coming up.
Hurricane season is here, so when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7.
We bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
And track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you. The all-new MySuncoast.com. Just another way, we're here for you.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the 5 best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352. 800-290-0352.
At Sunset Subaru in Sarasota, it's all about getting more for your money. More years, more miles, more 2016 IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus winners than any other brand. Stop by to see our new state-of-the-art showroom today, and you can lease the most award-winning small SUV on the planet, a new 2016 Subaru Forester, for just $229 a month, complimentary maintenance included, at Sunset Subaru in Sarasota. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
You know what scares me? No electricity.
Yeah. When this magical box suddenly stops working, I call the pros at Mr. Sparky and they send a superhero to save the day. How's it going, Pablo?
It's going great, Mike.
Pablo possesses amazing skill. He can perform incredible feats at blinding speed. Superhero!
Couldn't have done it without you.
Modest, too.
Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Just to be clear, I don't live here.
Whether you're a homeowner looking for a professional installation or a contractor looking for top quality products, Sarasota Glass and Mirror can meet your every need.
For 42 years, Sarasota Glass and Mirror has been the area's premier supplier and installer of quality glass products for your home or business. As an authorized PGT WinGuard dealer, we know how to protect your home. With everything from the PGT WinGuard impact-resistant windows and doors to shower enclosures and decorative mirrors, the Sarasota Glass and Mirror team has the knowledge to tackle any project.
Welcome back. It is 6:53, and here's what you need to know before you head out the door on this 4th of July. An accidental shooting at a local gun range leaves a 14-year-old dead. Police were called to the High Noon Gun Range on Bee Ridge Road yesterday afternoon, and an investigation continues. Not only is it the 4th of July holiday, but also the Powerboat Grand Prix races. Thousands hit the beaches this weekend, but was it as big of a success as previous years? And cities across the Suncoast are planning to hold their annual fireworks shows tonight. Most of the fireworks displays will kick off after dark at 9 o'clock. As far as your commute right now at 6:54, let's head to those maps. We are still seeing a little problem out of Palmetto, US 41 southbound. There's partial blockage there at 23rd Street. And in Bayshore Gardens on El Conquistador Parkway, there's some debris in the road to watch out for at 43rd Street. The rest of our roadways look great into Sarasota. No slowdowns or accidents. And as far as Venice and Northport, no problems to report there either.
We're also going to take a look outside, and you can see the sun is shining. We only have a few clouds off in the distance. We're not expecting to see much in the way of rainfall throughout the morning hours or even this afternoon. Only a 20% chance of rain is in our forecast, but it is going to be a scorcher of a week. We've got temperatures in the 90s for the rest of the forecast period, and we've got overnight lows in the 70s. We keep our rain chances low through Wednesday with a 50% chance of rain on Thursday. So right now we're seeing a couple of showers located offshore. They're moving up towards the north, and we may get a stray shower this morning that comes on in, but very low chance.
Well, with it being the 4th of July, one thing is for sure. It's time for the annual Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest. Contestants were at Coney Island for the traditional pre-event weigh-in, and all eyes are on the 8-time champ, Joey Chestnut. He's trying to upset last year's winner, Matt Stoney. Stoney won the championship after downing 62 hot dogs in 10 minutes. So for those of you who can stomach watching it, this year's contest kicks off this afternoon. I love a good hot dog, but one is good enough for me. Yes. 62 in under 10 minutes. All no. I can say is good luck to him.
No.
Right?
Yes. That's all one can say.
And stay hydrated today if you are on the Suncoast, because it is hot.
Yes.
I need
it's
a couple
get
hot
up
dogs.
To about 93. Yeah. So it's going to be a scorcher of a day today.
Stick around. Good Morning America is coming up next. Have a great and safe holiday.